So let's continue with our NFT gallery on Solana. I've shown you how to run the UI and what package it actually uses, Solrays and Solrays React, which is, can be found on NPM. Here's instruction on how to use them. So before explaining how this function actually fetches NFTs on Solana, need to explain how the Solana actually works and how the Solana accounts work. So here's the diagram I made. It took me about a few months to understand all pieces. I will try to explain it so you will not need to spend so much time. Instead, spend it on building something cool. Let's say all this stuff is based on Solana, so this is Solana blockchain. And you can see here wallet, system program, token, program, my USDC account, my own wallet. All this stuff is just accounts, so it's the same thing. Just some of them can be run, some of them can hold information like what balance of SOL I have. Everything on Solana can be seen as accounts, as a files. Some files with some content inside of it. Some of them program. Some of them is just accounts which holds data like USDC amount, my wrapped SOL amount, my TagBirds, any other like Ray. I can hold some Rays. Some of them can be run and them call it programs, like program on operation system. I market them with robot emojis. So we have system program, for example, running on blockchain. We have associated token program. We have Metaplex token metadata, which is created by Metaplex organization itself. This Metaplex token metadata program is created by BPF upgradable loader. Any program on Solana is created by another program on Solana. And as you can see, all these accounts have some specific color. I marked it with color to identify which program have created this account. Because the only way to create account on Solana is using some programs. So only programs allowed to create accounts. If you want hold some USDC, someone need to create this account which will hold this information. How many USDC you hold? All these green accounts created by program called token program or a spell program. Written by Solana team. The main purpose of it is create SPL tokens, NFT tokens, fungible tokens, unfungible tokens, whatever. There is a system program and my wallet or your wallet created by this system program. And some NFTs information we need to find is created by Metaplex token metadata program. Each of this account have their own address, as you can see, like I marked here. So token program have its address, your wallet have its address, system program also have its address. And for example, you have created wallet with system program. It can show you this in more details on Solana Explorer. Let's check it. And you can see this is created by system program, which is also have its own address, like all ones. And native loader used to create this system program. So you can see my wallet. And actually wallet have very general information like SOL balance. I have one SOL. It holds information about address, who's created this account, allocated data, is it executable or not. But what wallet doesn't store is your tokens. We need to ask Solana in separate call to provide us all tokens associated with this wallet. So for example, I have my account for some USDC, my NFT. This account's associated with my wallet, but stored separately and created by token program. As you can see on this diagram, my USDC, my NFTs have same color. I made them same color to show you that at the nutshell, they actually the same and they call it SPL tokens. If you want to buy some Ray token, for example, you need to create associated account with this Ray, some new account to hold this Ray. For example, it will be my Ray. We'll color it green and it will be attached, associated with your wallet. And now when you have, you can buy some Rays or someone can send you this Rays from their own MyRay account. This Ray token is just a representation of the SPL token. To hold some amount of it, you need to create your own account. And it will say that you have 10 Rays, for example. This representation of the token is called Mint. You can create your own SPL tokens, you can create your own mints, but each coin or each NFT should have only one mint. So why I'm telling you all this story about Rays? Because NFTs is the same SPL token and they work in the same rules. When you want to buy NFT, you need to create associated account for it. So you need to create account which can hold this amount of NFT. You don't really hold this account which is called mint, you hold instead some amount of this token. But in case of NFTs, most time it will be one, supply will be one, but you're free to have like 5,000 NFTs of same mint and you will have like 10,000 NFTs of token A. But most likely you will have one and only one. Yeah, let's explore this on Solana Explorer. And you can see this account associated with my wallet. And here's the field mint, which point to this token. So inside of this token, we have information what is the mint of this program. And I can click on mint. And as you see, Solana Explorer show me the NFT itself. It's not so short story because they kind of do some magic hidden from your eyes. I will explain it in a bit. But this is really close to your NFT. So when we want to parse wallet NFTs, we need to find some account which stores this information, because most likely we need like image and name and description and some traits. And to find this information, we need to start from finding what SPL accounts we hold. We need to find which one is NFT we're looking for. And when we have this account, we can parse it and find what is the mint of this token. I will show you in the code what we have found so far. All this Solana magic done inside of function get parsed NFT accounts by owner inside of the SolRace package. So here's the code. At the start, we just check is provided public address is valid address, valid Solana address, because actually you can pass anything to it and we don't need to go further if it's not valid address. Next, you can see these lines of code which use function get parse token accounts by owner provided by Solana Web3 package inside of connection object. So get parse token accounts by owner is what will return you all of these tokens, associated token accounts you hold. To this function, we need to provide the address of the owner, and here's also the filter, which will filter accounts only created by specific program. In this case, we only want accounts created by token program, because this is the only program who can create SPL tokens. All this Ray, USDC and our NFTs. This is the only program who can do it. We can filter it by this program ID. So let's see what we have at this point, SPL accounts. So I'm running this package locally, so I can do some updates and show you the result. Let's see what inside of this result returned by get parse token accounts. Here's a list of tokens held by my account. And what information we have here is really basic SPL token information. I will remind you that all this stuff is created by token program, and token program doesn't know anything about NFTs metadata like images, description text. It creates this every account with same structure, and this structure looks like this. It have information like who is minter, who is owner, token amount hold in this account, like this USDC for example, which amount. It says some token which is zero amount. Probably could be many accounts with zero amount, because when you send your USDC for example somewhere, it just said that you have amount of USDC zero. An account still here, it's still available. Same about NFT, if you will send it somewhere or sell it, it just set your account to zero value. So that could be pretty lot of stuff. Not much useful for us except mint of this token, which token is related. So at this point, we can filter out all of these tokens, SPL tokens we don't need, and just go with our NFTs. Because as I said, NFTs is actually same SPL token, but with decimals, and usually it's amount at least one. We can't really hold like half of NFT A. And next, get Solana metadata address, we're going to find accounts which hold metadata for our account. Because this mint also doesn't really hold information we need, like images, NFT description. It holds pretty same information like this account. Supply, who is owner of it, who minted it, and such things. The actual metadata is stored inside of third token account, third token associated account. You see it's pink color, it's created by Metaplex token metadata. I will remind you, token program can't create tokens which will hold such things like NFTs metadata. So Metaplex create its own program which can create such accounts which hold this information. But we don't know the address of this token metadata. Likely we can easily find it if we know mint NFT of token related to this token metadata and program address who have created this token metadata. At this point, we will use another program on Solana blockchain, which is called associated token program. So if you will take this associated token program and pass to it mint of NFT A and address of Metaplex token metadata, it will return you the address of token metadata. This program knows rules at which it was created, and this rules is kind of combining both two addresses and finding some suitable Solana address for this token metadata. So it doesn't store any information, but it knows the rules on which it was created. So each time you will ask her about it, it knows how to calculate this token metadata and it will return this address to you. We can do it with simple operation like this, which is called find program address. Inside of public key from Solana Web3 package. So we call this find program address and pass as arguments meta program prefix buffer. So it's kind of seed for our address. It will be meta program public key buffer and token mint. So we send the seed, which is meta, NFT mint and token public key. And what it will return us is a list of all possible token accounts. And we have a bunch of these responses from Solana, the list of these token metadata accounts. I will output this data to show you what we have at this stage. So as you see, we have 20 public keys. All of them is combination of this mint token address and Metaplex public address. So now we have just a list of public keys and we need to request all of them for information. And here we divide this list in chunks by 99 and we ask blockchain to provide us information by chunks, by these chunks. So if we have 200 tokens, we have two requests. At this point, we probably will find the data inside of this token metadata. And we're really close to what we're looking for, NFTs metadata. I will remind you, or if you didn't know it, I will tell you that inside of this accounts, data is stored not really like human readable way, but in bytes, and so call it buffer type. Just bunch of bytes like this thing. So we need to decode this information to understand. We can decode it with package called Borsch, which we use to deserialize this byte data. We need to pass to this function the rules at which we want to pass this buffer. I will say on high level, the rules is something like you explain to this function that first 4 bytes, for example, will be about name. Next 16 bytes will be something like URI and so on. It just decoded this information. This schema which use it to decode it is provided by Metaplex. I can show you how it looks like. So here's schema, the data, metadata. It just explains this to this Borsch function, how you can decode it. And here's the data structure we will have after decode. Name, symbol, URI, seller basis, creators, constructor. So we finally got this information about metadata and we have decoded it. At this point, we again need to remove all unsuccessful promises because this decode function return promise filter out all failed and just forget about them. Then we do another filter which filter out all accounts which doesn't have proper information we can use. Specifically, filter out all NFTs which doesn't have URI field. Really hard to display them if we don't have information about them. So we filter it out. Next, what we do is some sanitizing for our strings. Because as you can see at this point, there are some weird symbols inside of strings. This symbol U000 is actually some kind of Rust white space symbol, white space generated by Rust program. And we need to actually remove all this stuff. We don't want to pass it further to end user. And then we do another thing here is mapping our all public keys to strings. Now we have these accounts, we sanitize it and stringify it. And we do here one more useful stuff, which is actually you most likely want to see when you get your NFTs. We sort them by update authority with idea that same collection created, most likely created by same update authority. Update authority is the wallet who can update this token and most likely wallet who have created these tokens. It's not very reliable to say that single collection have only one update authority, but You probably want to see them sorted at least a bit. And at this point, we return all this data we have. So this is what this function getParsedNFTAccounts by owner returns. And now you probably can get the whole picture of this stuff. By the way, in package, you can find the here's description for each of the option connection, sanitize, strict NFTs, etc. Probably all I was want to tell you about. Hope you got some useful information from these videos. Hit the like button and also start these packages on the GitHub, this package, and here's another create dapp Solana next.js. Anyway, thank you. Bye.